I just love meeting all of you. Welcome, my little learners, to another activity video for the chapter A Seed Tells a Farmer's Story. You know, I woke up in the morning longing for a biryani. But when I opened my rice box, this is what I saw. I guess these insects wanted to finish up the rice before I could. Sadly, I ended up in a bad mood and started thinking of the options that I could use to protect my grains and pulses from these insects. I then surfed my kitchen and found out a lot of options that could help me out. Few of them I'm going to share with you today. But before I share the things with you, I'm also going to share some tips with you. Before we store our grains, we have to make sure that the container in which we are storing our grains is completely dry. If it is not dry, you are going to use a clean cloth to wipe it up. And even if you feel still there is some kind of moisture content in the container, you are going to keep it under the sunlight. Then the second thing you have to keep in mind is the container in which you are storing your grains and pulses should be airtight. And whenever next you are going to take out the grains and pulses from the container, your hands should not be wet. They should be dry and moisture free. Fine. So let us start with the things that I'm going to show you today. Have a close look. These are all the things that are easily available at home in your kitchen. What you have to do is, here I have a box in which I have pulses. So these are neem leaves. Whenever we are storing our grains, especially before the monsoon season, we can add neem leaves to our containers. This will prevent the insects to breed in the box. Similarly, we can also use kadi patta. It is also called sweet neem. But make sure these all leaves are dry and moisture free. These all can also be added in the containers, storage containers. Then another thing that I have here is bay leaves. These you usually put in biryanis and pulavs. These are also called tej pattas. These can also be added in our flour and our pulses to prevent the insects to multiply. Then red chilies can also be added. Here I have few matchsticks. Matchsticks have sulfur and prevents the insects to multiply in large numbers in the grains and pulses. Here I have garlic, जिसे हम हिंदी में लहसुन कहते हैं, इसे भी हम ऐड कर सकते हैं हमारे कंटेनर्स में, स्पेशली राइस एंड पल्सेस. देन अनदर थिंग आई हैव क्लोव्स. क्लोव्स के हमें बेनिफिट्स ऑलरेडी मालूम हैं, कितने इसके हेल्थ बेनिफिट्स हैं और ये कितना फ्लेवरसम होता है. ये एक काम और करता है, ये आपकी ग्रेन्स को और जो पल्सेस हैं उनको बचा कर रखता है. वन मोर थिंग, मस्टर्ड ऑयल. दिस कैन डू मैजिक. वॉट यू हैव टू डू इज जस्ट अ टी स्पून और टू टी स्पून्स वी आर गोइंग टू एड इन आर पल्सेज लाइक दिस एंड देन मिक्स इट प्रॉपरली. दिस विल कीप योर थिंग्स सेफ फॉर लॉन्ग, फॉर मेनी डेज. See, I've given it a good mix. Now, as we are done with this, I would like to bring another thing to your notice. We live in India and we celebrate a lot of festivals in India. There are many festivals that are related to farming. Now, what you have to do is take out your E2Lab file. On the left side, what you have to do is you have to mention the name of any such festival which is related to farming. There are many festivals: Onam, Pongal, Makar Sankranti, and Baisakhi. You can choose any one and write the name here, the season in which it is celebrated, the states that popularly celebrate it, and the special food which is cooked on this festival. Here on the right side, you can draw or paste a picture of the people celebrating this festival, you know, the entire theme. So after doing this, you have to send this page to your EVS teacher and also guide your mother in the kitchen that how you can contribute in keeping all the food items safe at home. Thank you.